Hey everybody, welcome back to another video. We got ourselves a GC1 analysis, fresh squeezy, 1440 MMR. What's funny was that I forgot to put this replay file in my demo folder, so I was actually recording your previous one. And I noticed until you did that kickoff where you hit it with the ass of your car when you jumped up in the air and you did that weird backflip, if you remember. From the previous video, and I was like, wait a minute, didn't I already do this already? I remember him doing that weird kickoff. So, luckily I caught that, because that would have been pretty bad if I just recorded the same thing. Alright, so, good try off the kickoff here. Good pressure, nice. Okay, so anybody who's in GC1, and they don't know what to do to improve, now is the time to figure out what you can do off the ball to help out your teammate. Also, you gotta perfect your challenges. When do you want to challenge? How do you challenge? Is it safe to challenge? Is he gonna beat me first? Am I gonna have a beat on him? You know what I mean? How do I 50 this so it's not gonna be a loss on the 50? You know what I mean? Like, this is what you gotta start thinking about. So far, good plays. But it looks like you get absolutely demolished. So what is it? 4-2, 1-2-3-4. Okay, so it's 4-5. Your loss. So good. Another loss. It'd be nice to replay this, or be nice to analyze this, because you learn the most from games that you lose. Heavy touch. Next time, get a softer touch. Okay, this is a weird thing. You're probably confused what the hell is going on here. Now, I see why you go back. It's because you see your teammate pushing up, right? From his car language, it looks like he's going to go after this, but he doesn't. I have no idea why he doesn't. He's clearly the closest to the ball. I don't know what he's doing. Doesn't see you at all. Yeah, he's flicking his camera. He's waiting on you to do something, but the funny thing is, you're all the way in middle, so you wouldn't really need to go after this. This is just really confusing. If your teammate was more aggressive here, this would have helped a lot, because now you're just giving them free time. On the ball, which you don't want. Okay, if you want to have a better challenge, use the side of your car or the roof of your car. Because you hit it with the nose of your car, which is what you don't want. So this is what I mean. You have to be constantly... you have to be consciously 50-ing. Yeah, so you kind of hit it with, like, the front portion of your car. Try to turn your car just a little bit more, and then dodge to the side. Probably wouldn't have had this weird 50. I wouldn't follow this way. I would go out and get small pads, because it becomes much easier. Yeah, see? It's just on the nose of your car. So anyways, I would get down, go this way, right? Okay, and turn back around, and then I would wait, do something else. You gotta find the optimal route when you rotate back. You just messed up your mechanic there. I think you tried to flip, but you just ran out of the time when you can flip. That's a bit unfortunate. A good shot. You see that he's overcommitted on the wall here, right? He's going for big boost, so him turning around against this really fast shot is not likely. That's exactly what happens. So that's a good play. So you guys are doing really well. You guys aren't making major mistakes. I think that could have been avoided, not gonna lie, but it is what it is. You're up 3 points. Yeah, you could have scored that, but it's all good. Alright, you're about to get scored on soon, so let's see what happens. Okay, it just, again, it's, well, not again. I said this in the video that that I mistakenly recorded for the second time. Because I noticed this is what happened in the previous video, is that you get heavy touches. You don't want to get touches like this. You got to try to control it better, right? I see you're trying to push it off the front of your car, which is fine, but you just do it too late, and it actually touches the ground first, so then it pops up. So make sure you get those softer touches, because a lot of the times you just throw away possession like that. Yeah, again, it's just hesitating. You don't need to hesitate here. You see Kelly is right here. You saw him turn away again. So you don't need to stop. Just go. And obviously, funny side is he can't reach it in time. But since you hesitated, he was able to reach it. And look, I think your teammate bumped him. Yeah, your teammate bumps him in the end. So you could have possibly scored. You're just missing opportunities. And what happens here? From a teammate's point of view. Yeah, that's a weird... I'm surprised that didn't demo. Yeah, it's just unfortunate. Unfortunate bump there. It just goes in their favor. Just don't hesitate next time. You also start noticing that... You have to make a decision, and you have to stick with it. You gotta make decisions faster, and you can't, like, flake out of it. That's a better 50. You use the side of your car more. That's why the 50 was better. Yeah, it looks like you guys get scored on again here soon. Okay. Nice defense. Nice. Okay, yep. No one's challenging, right? You gotta pay attention to what they're doing. Look, Kelly's running away, and Funny is all the way back there. So no one's challenging this. Just catch the ball again. Or wait until... You see he has full boost. Wait until the ball comes closer to the wall, and then push it to the left so your teammate can catch it. Now with this, you completely screw yourself. Now you're floating in the air for too long. You have no boost. Okay. You jumped too early here. I would have... just drive a little longer. Like, I know this looks scary that he might hit this early, but... At least you can tell the ball is rolling over here. So, just try to meet up with where it's gonna go. Because I feel like if you didn't jump, you would have probably saved this. Oh, you know what? You could actually recognize earlier that this is a problem. Why? Because your teammate throws away possession, right? Look, he hits the ball into the corner. It's going to bounce out into middle. Okay, that means they're going to get it. You can't get this because you got zero boost. So recognize that he threw away a possession. Prioritize going back. So take these pads. Don't go to the last one. Why don't you just take this, these two, and then these three. And then you can go save it. That can work too. I think that is a lot better to do rather than what I said before. So just, you have to be aware instantly. Like from this quick motion, you have to know immediately you have to get back rather than rotating so wide, right? Notice how if your teammate hits the ball really hard, it's probably going to be their ball next. So, like this, for example. Whose ball is it? It's theirs. You don't want to hit this ball so hard. And if you do, you got to make sure teammate can get this. Now, you can't make sure because you want to actually pass this, which isn't bad, actually. But he's just so freaking far away. Look how far he is. He's all the way back here. And he's probably got faster momentum than your teammate does. Yeah, so... it's just stupid, unfortunate. Oh, man. I guess you could say you can try to demo this guy. Now that you see him on your right, try to just stop moving and get behind him on purpose, and then try to bump him. And just trust that Funny is not going to score it. That's another way you can save this. It's just you're giving possession away. Yeah, I think teammate made you pause, honestly. I think you tried to go after this, but then teammate's in the way. Yawning. It's unfortunate. I wish your teammate didn't rotate right in front of you like that. Alright, don't go after this. You're beat. Trust me. That's what I'm talking about. Now that you're in Grand Champ, you gotta be picky with your challenges, right? You're only going after this because it looks like you can just hit the ball in if he fails. Did he fail? Absolutely not. Look, he landed on the wall. Well, actually, no. He didn't land on the wall. But either way, he's still closer to the ball. Don't underestimate your opponents. I'm sure they can find a way to fix themselves and they can hit the ball again. So this is a terrible idea. Remember, you only got 23 boosts, right? Let's see how quickly you can recover off of this. Okay, it's pretty decent, but I'm just saying, if for some reason you're even more stuck in the net with no boost, your recovery would suck. Good coverage. You gotta take your time here. Okay, it's fine. They're trying the cut. Nice shot from teammate. Alright, this looks like you get scored on twice. You guys are about to win. You have 30 seconds. Ah. That's wild. Okay, it's just you flipped weird because you front flipped when your nose was straight up. So you're not really going to have momentum going forward. Now, you got to recognize that this is a potential passing play. You see Kelly's is wide open. You got to turn sooner. Even if it's just... oh, I just voice cracked a little bit. But if you just... I think if you start boosting here... and just getting hella aggressive... you might be able to stop him in time. Even when you're like this, like right here, power slide into the boost so that you can turn sooner and grab 100 at the same time. So then you'd be like this. You'd be like this. And you can go get the ball. I wouldn't try to demo him because if you miss, then he's still going to score. But I'm sure you can definitely beat him to the ball because you were close just from what you did before. Right? So if you kept boosting a little faster and you recognized that there was going to be a pass sooner, you would have stopped this 100%. And then teammate is all weird from the previous play. Right? So he can't help you with this. Alright. So it looks like we go into overtime. Nothing really happens for the next 22 seconds. Good try on the shot. I think this is a bit of an overcommit here. Again, you have 8 boost. if you dodge, right, you're going to be stuck in the air for a long time, right? Why not just play pressure? You don't have to try to go after this ball so aggressively. You're first man. Your job is to make them awkward. So, why not just fake challenge? Just go up and then turn around. Get this big boost. Now you're behind teammate. Right? You wait over here for a second. And then you can go after it. But be farther back, obviously. You don't have to get so close. Because look, you're getting too close to the play. A 50 is about to happen. You don't want to get too close. So, I would position more behind your teammate like this. And you can go after it. Holy shit. It's just you guys' defense and ball touches aren't good. It's not efficient enough. That's why you guys are having a huge problem. Like, you almost get scored on here. It's because you're just too slow. Like, this is dangerous. You gotta recognize something can happen here, right? Funny has you don't know he has a lot of boost, but Funny is definitely gonna go after this, and you're last. Teammate can't help you, so you're gonna have to actually just rush this away sooner. Again, if you recognize that sooner, right? You go like this. You dust this guy, hit it off the wall, bounces back in. Teammate can just turn around. Probably could have scored here and won the game. I mean, this is quick. Like, you gotta be so efficient. Like, I know this sounds like crazy. Like, how can I even react to that in time? But you just have to. Like, this is the game sense and vision that I'm trying to teach you guys. That you gotta recognize threats way sooner than everybody else can. And if you didn't want to go after this, you can actually sit back. Why? Because there's so much space. Right? Look where he hits the ball. All the way back here. If you positioned right here, you can easily save it if you wanted to. You would have time. Again, you threw away the ball. Actually, don't backflip into this. Look how far away Funny Side is. He has no momentum. He's literally sitting in net. Look, see? He does not even moving. You can see on your screen, right? Let's watch this again. Watch Funny Side. He's backing up into freaking net. Right? He's not going after this because he knows you have the beat. 100%. He'd be stupid to go after this. Why don't you turn the car around and then go after the ball? Notice how heavy touches. You give away possession. Right? Heavy touch here. Now nobody can follow this up. So now it goes into their play. Oh, yep. I've done that plenty of times. I'm dead serious. This happens a lot more than you think. This is just a matter of just knowing how quickly you should be going up the wall to meet up with the ball. This is just a mechanical error. Yeah, that's so unfortunate. So again, nothing really to say here. You had the right idea. It's just you didn't boost in time to get up to the wall sooner. So this wasn't really a game sense issue. It's just you just failed mechanically. So for this replay, it looks like you hit the ball way too like hard so often. You don't want to give away possession, right? Make sure you look at the opponents too. There are a lot of times where they kind of give up space and you can use it to take your time and dribble or set up a better play. So you have to look at your opponents and you have to choose the right thing to do, right? You got to understand how to challenge. And that's really the secret in Grand Champ, is that if you start improving how you challenge and understanding what's worth the going for and what's not, you'll start realizing that you're gonna be not only back on defense sooner because you know what's more of a threat, you'll also be less overcommitting, and you'll have more chances to score. Why? Because if you know when to challenge, right, that can also mean you know when's the right time to attack. So it's all about challenging and game sense and understanding what your opponents are giving you. So just focus on that, those things, for Grand Champ 1. Yes, that's it for this video. Hopefully this helps you get into Grand Champ 2. To anybody else who's in Grand Champ 1, hopefully this helps you too. If you guys enjoyed, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and comment, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.